This Deadpool mask is probably one of the easiest cosplay items I've ever printed, and that's out of two. So, not a lot of things, but this did print really easily, and it came out fantastic. Let's check this thing out and talk about the build process. And even better, even if you don't have a 3D printer, I can show you how you can use the today's sponsor, PCBWay, to print one of these out. But we'll get into that in just a little bit. This is definitely not going to be a how-to video on how to build this. Mostly. I'm still new to this, so I'm just kind of sharing my experience as I build this. First and foremost, I found this over on MakerWorld by the creator of Budwin, who has actually done a lot of cool things. So now, check this out. Everything is magnetized. You take off the eyes. And this is how you can print everything together and also get it on your head to actually wear this. Looking at this, this thing printed so amazingly. The way that the creator of the file had these like textures in here, everything just printed so nice. Now, I did have to scale this one up for myself because this did not fit on my head as stock. I had to reprint it and actually scale it up to, I wanna say 105%. The main shell is going to be the red PLA from Bamboo Lab. The black is Sunlu PLA, and the white eyes are actually PETG High Flow. Now I used about half a roll of filament for the red and about maybe like a tenth or 100-150 grams for the black, and just even a small amount for the eyes because, you know, they honestly don't take up that much. I did print this at 0.2 layer lines, which was the basic from the file over on MakerWorld. And you know what? The detail on this is just phenomenal. You didn't really need to do any post-processing on this. This is just straight off the printer with the exception of adding the magnets and gluing in the eyes. So I printed this over on my A1 Mini and also my Bamboo Lab X1 Carbon. The total print time and assembly didn't take all that long, to be honest with you. I didn't have any issues printing this. Everything printed out pretty nicely. You do need to use supports on some of the prints, but you can see here on the bottom, some of this actually was a bit rough because of the supports, but you know, I could come in and file that down and use a little torch to kind of like smooth that back out a little bit. One of the hardest things about building this was actually putting in all the magnets. Now, on one of my last videos about using some magnets, some people left some great tips. I'll have to use those for the next time. This thing is awesome. The file does say that you are able to press fit the magnets in. That was kind of hit or miss for myself. I actually had to use some pliers to push them in sometimes, as well as using some super glue to make sure that they stayed in there. Let's actually put this thing on so you can see how well it fits on my head after scaling it up to like, I think 105%. Getting it on is actually a little bit difficult. I recommend getting rid of about half of it. So that way you can kind of slide it over. Bring this side over. There we go. And now the back. Oh, dang it. All right, let's try this again. It is actually quite a bit a tight fit for myself still. It is a bit of a tight fit, man. I really wish I could remember if I did 105%, but it does fit a little bit tight, especially right here on the sides of my head. And ideally, I think if I were to wear this for a longer period of time, I would actually add some foam in the top of the head to kind of just make sure I bring this up a little bit so I can actually look through the eyes. And you can actually look through these eyes fairly easily. So now, if you don't have a 3D printer and you want to print this, you could use the sponsor of today's video, PCBWay. PCBWay is an online service provider for everything between 3D printing, metal 3D printing, sheet metal fabrication, PCB boards. They do a ton of stuff, but if you want to get one of these yourself and you don't have a 3D printer, you could use them to get this printed and built up, and you just gotta get the magnets yourself. Thank you to PCBWay for sponsoring today's video. Let's get back to it. If you wanna see some more cosplay stuff like this, let me know down in the comments below. This was kind of fun to do and really interesting. I'll have links down below for the magnets that I used, as well as the files for this if you wanna check it out and go support Budwin over on MakerWorld. or printables or Thingiverse. I'm sure he's on all of them. This is Adam from the Rad Dad Print Lab, and YouTube thinks you should check out this video right here before you go.